the men's competition with last year's world champion Todd Eldridge, Russia's rising star Ilia Kulik, the powerful Canadian former world champion Elvis Stojko, and the leader, Olympic champion Aleksei Urnanov. When we return to Lausanne, Switzerland, and the World Figure Skating Championships, presented by MasterCard. It has captured the imagination of the skating world, and it just may decide the world championship, the quadruple jump.
It feels like you're holding on forever, basically. It's sweet.
The quad has to be in there if everyone's skating strongly.
Two-time world champion Elvis Stojko of Canada stands in fourth place after the short program. Last year's silver medalist Ilia Kulik of Russia is in third. Then there's the reigning world champion, Todd Eldridge of the United States. All are in close pursuit of Russia's Aleksei Urnanov, the leader. Four men, 4+ minutes. Will it come down to four revolutions? In the wonderful shadow of the Alps, the city of Lausanne, Switzerland, the Olympic capital, and it welcomes Olympic-style competition this week. Welcome back to the Malay Ice Center and the 1997 World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. We are ready now for the men's free skate. Hello again, everybody. I'm Brent Musburger. The United States has produced a remarkable collection of world champions, and Todd Eldridge added his name to that list a year ago. Defending his title, though, here tonight is going to be very difficult. He faces a formidable collection of challengers, including the Russian Aleksei Urnanov and Ilia Kulik and the Canadian Elvis Stojko. It has been a decade since an American successfully defended a world title. The last to do so, Scott Hamilton. He captured four consecutive world titles between 1981 and 1984. And Scott tonight is very much on our minds. As we mentioned earlier, he has been diagnosed with testicular cancer. The prognosis is favorable for a full recovery, and all of us at ABC Sports wish him the very best, a sentiment I know that I share with my colleagues, Terry Gannon, Dick Button, and Brian Boitano.
Well, Brent, the events of the past 24 hours certainly have been disheartening, and Dick, I know that both Carlo Fassi and Scott Hamilton have been very important people in your life.
You know, the first time I met Carlo Fassi was exactly 50 years ago this week when we competed in the 1947 World Figure Skating Championships in Stockholm. He was the national Italian champion. And for the following half century, his humor, his powerful influence, his wit, his political savvy, his infectious laugh, his teaching genius, and crazy jokes lit up all our lives. Carlo, I miss you already. And I certainly hope you, Scott Hamilton, are watching this program because all your friends here, and there are a lot of them, are sending you the biggest high five you've ever seen. Keep the faith, pal.
Well, Scott Hamilton has to know that he has legions of fans all around the world, three of them right here. And Brian, you not only have competed against Scott Hamilton, but I know that you've looked up to him for some time, too.
Yeah, Terry. Through all the years I've known Scott Hamilton, he's been my role model and, more importantly, my friend. And Scott, you know, I add my healing energy to yours to help you fight through this.
Well, the World Championships do continue here in Lausanne, and as we turn our attention back to the men's free skate, the focus all week has been on the quad, the four revolution jump that may be the deciding factor tonight. And Brian, you've had that as a part of your competitive programs throughout your career. What does it take to land the quad?
Well, Terry, the secret to the quadruple jump is quickness. As you can see in Elvis Stojko's quadruple toe loop, the takeoff is the same as in a triple or a double. But to complete four revolutions, you have to get from the takeoff into the first rotation quicker and maintain that speed of rotation throughout the jump.
Well, Todd Eldridge, the defending world champion, is one who is not expected to attempt a quad jump, and whether that proves to be a smart move or not depends largely, of course, upon the judges. Dick, how will the whole quad issue affect the judging?
Well, look, you know, the judges, they're just like you and me, and what impresses us impresses them. One of the great elements of skating is flight. When you jump, you have flight. and you have to fly to complete four revolutions. Now that's got to be exciting, and anyone who says that it isn't has never experienced flying on ice. So while I'm always saying a competition should not be exclusively jump-oriented, I must admit that this is terrific. And besides, who cares anyway if there are a few falls involved?
Quad mania running rampant here in Lausanne. Can Todd Eldridge repeat as world champion? We'll have the men's championship free skate coming up next.
Aleksei Urnanov, after the short program, suffered a slight groin injury. We don't know how he'll be affected. Todd Eldridge of the United States, the defender, is in second. There you can see Michael Weiss, also of the United States, is in ninth place right now. Now the final group, and in discussing this with Dick Button, he says that Ilia Kulik could be at an advantage being the first skater, and he has a chance to win the gold tonight if he captures the free skating competition. Eldridge and Urnanov are two of the final skaters here tonight. One of the surprises of the men's competition is Israel's Michael Shmerkin. But overcoming long odds is really nothing new for him. The story of his life is one of scaling seemingly insurmountable obstacles. He pours his soul onto the ice, but the ice shows no compassion for the path his soul has taken. In Ukraine, where Misha Shmerkin grew up, he was told that Russian Jews couldn't represent the Soviet Union abroad. So his parents devised a scheme to sidestep the authorities.
When I began to make progress in figure skating, there became a question of nationality. What to do to become Russian? My parents decided to divorce. It was a very uneasy step. Then my mother had to have a fictitious paper marriage. That was how I became Russian.
When Misha was 21, his family moved to the Jewish homeland, Israel. Now it was his turn to sacrifice.
I understood that I had to give up skating. I had to give up everything. But at this present date, I don't regret that we have left. My parents wanted a better life for their children.
At Israel's lone regulation-sized rink, Uzis are as commonplace as skates. It's located in the north, near a desolate road, which separates two countries, two cultures. Here, along the Israeli-Lebanese border, Misha now trains and raises his family with bomb shelters, a constant reminder of the danger.
I'm a fatalist. If it is destined, it is destined. You can't hide here. For instance, we are talking now, and the missile may be here any moment, and you can't do anything.
So he skates, maybe more for ideals than medals. In 1994, he became Israel's first and only delegate to the Winter Olympics. But the scars on his soul remain. 1995. Skate Canada.
An athlete said to me, "Misha, your president has been killed."
Eyewitnesses say the shooting occurred at close range. A suspected gunman has been arrested.
I was shocked. I couldn't imagine a Jew could raise a hand against a Jew. Our federation had told me, "You are now representing Israel. Show them what you can do."
Done!
His finest performance, forever linked to his country's darkest hour, Yitzhak Rabin's assassination. No, the ice may never know the path his soul has taken, but Misha knows.
For me, it was a great honor that I was the first to say, "Yes, I am Jewish, and I want to represent Israel." They say a stranger will always be a stranger. This is my country, and for Israel, I'll never be a stranger.
Well, Brent, he has faced so much adversity in his life, and everything that he has accomplished, he has certainly earned. Michael Shmerkin in eighth place after the short program representing Israel. Here he is on the world stage.
He's going to really need to fight during this program, because in the six minute warm-up, he had a very tough time. He wasn't rotating straight at all in the air, and you could see it was frustrating him.
Triple flip jump. A double. Triple axel, double toe. A double axel, rather. Remember, the fact that he changes his mind and does something that is perfectly acceptable does not deduct any marks from his program. He can simply do the other one that he had planned or might have wished to do at a later point.
That's the jump that he missed in the warm-up, and he still was a little tilted in the air on that.
I suspect there's an enormous amount of pressure on him, that he really takes that the fact that he's carrying his country on his back in this ice rink.
Well, it's interesting, Dick, if Michael Shmerkin ends up in the top 10, Israel would be eligible to send two skaters to next year's World Championships and the Olympics. Michael's the only one right now skating on this level.
Here's his next triple axel attempt. During these slow parts in a guy's program, a lot of time you'll try to regroup. And if you've had a bad opening, you have a little slow time to skate around and sort of get your mental capacity back.
Are you thinking about rearranging your program at this point, too?
Not usually you don't think of that, but it's a fresh new start when you start building up for the jump again after you've had a little bit of a rest.
It isn't so much rearranging the program, it's simply placing a jump that you may not have completed, but have done something perfectly acceptable, like a double instead of a triple axel, of placing that triple axel later. And most of the time, you have a place for that already worked out.
A little crooked in the air on that, but he saved it. He fought through that one.
Great spinner. Very few laybacks.
A little tough on that triple loop, but under rotated by a quarter of a turn.
That was just a total failure.
Well, you know, when you make so many mistakes in a program, it's exhausting because it ruins your momentum that you're used to in practice.
Not a great performance for Michael Shmerkin.
Well, he's had to overcome so much adversity just to be able to compete. An appreciative hand from the audience. Michael Shmerkin of Israel. Coming up next, the silver medalist in the U.S. Championships. We'll see if Michael Weiss has the quad jump in his program tonight. After this message and a word from our ABC stations.
News at 5:30, 6, and 6:30.
How does the new Bissell Microlock compare to ordinary vacuums? Let's take a look. The Microlock has a 7-stage microfiltration system, so it traps over 99% of dust particles and allergens inside the bag, instead of blowing them back into the air, like ordinary vacuums. Bissell. Life's messy. Clean it up. Available at your local Kmart.
The Wave. Listen to Southern California's smooth jazz radio station, 94.7 The Wave.
The Campbell Soups Tour of World Figure Skating Champions, coming to these LA area arenas July 11th, 12th, and 13th. Tickets on sale at the arenas and Ticketmaster, or charge by phone.
College fraternities move to ban the booze at 11.
You're watching the World Figure Skating Championships presented.
Michael Shmerkin of Israel in eighth place after the short program. And it was not a good night for him. His technical merit marks, there they are.
4-6, 4-6, second mark, 4-9, 5-3, 4-8, 5-5.
His free skate counting for 2/3 of the overall score. There are his presentation marks.
Thank you. On the ice, Michael Weiss, United States of America.
He thought he had completed the quad at the U.S. Championships. It was not ratified. We'll see if he can pull it off tonight. In ninth place, hoping to move up, here is 20-year-old Michael Weiss.
And the second jump that he does is the quadruple toe loop, and there's a lot of strategy for these guys. Sometimes they do it early to get it over with. Sometimes they do it later so that they can have a jump before to warm themselves back up. Michael does it second, using the triple lutz beforehand to warm up.
He would be the first American to land the quad in competition.
Here he's getting ready for his triple lutz. And this is what he says is a warm-up, because it's an easy triple for him.
Nice, clean position.
Now that he's warmed up again, he's going to go for the quadruple toe loop right here.
Oh, a triple. But very nice and clean one. You know, it looked like he didn't plan it.
He had a lot of trouble in the warm-up with that quadruple. I don't know if he hit one. His triple axel, triple toe is the one that he had a little bit of trouble on in the short program by two-footing the second jump's landing. And he did a double axel.
There was a triple axel.
That was supposed to be a split triple flip,
but it didn't. He was trying to replace it, and it didn't work.
Now the question is he going to throw the triple flip in somewhere else?
Would you?
I didn't usually change things. I would keep things as they were.
The music, remember, Abraxas by Carlos Santana.
comes another attempt at that triple axel.
Combination, triple axel, triple toe loop, and just squeaked it out. First jump was wonderful, though.
There is another American here competing in the men's competition, although he failed to get out of the qualifying rounds, Dan Hollander, so we will not see him skate, but it makes the finish of Michael Weiss and Todd Eldridge extremely important, the new point system for next year's Worlds.
You know, I have to say that when you make changes like that, it's very exhausting because you're just not used to the way that program's set up differently. There's that triple flip that he added right there.
Yep. Part of the problem is it takes more energy out of you to rethink and regroup than it does just to do it the way you've relaxed into it all along.
It's hard enough to keep your concentration out there, but when you're thinking of how to change things so that it can benefit your technical mark, it's difficult.
Watch these moving, flying, running camels into a camel spin. Jump over sit spin.
There's his fiance and choreographer, Lisa Thornton. She likes what she just saw on the ice. How about you guys?
I think that program is one that, because of its slightly off-center style of choreography, because it is an unusual program, needs really perfect technique.
Michael Weiss of the USA. And getting ready backstage, Aleksei Urnanov, he'll skate in the final group, nursing a groin pull. We'll have to wait and see how effective he can be. The men's free skate continues in a moment. Weiss had planned a quadruple toe. It became a triple toe, though, Dick.
And look at it here, very neat and clean. It just wasn't a quadruple. And at this level competition, wow, the sky's the limit.
This may be the year that changes everything in the men's competition. You may indeed need the quad from now on to win a world championship.
Well, I certainly think that that helped, will help Elvis Stojko if he does one tonight.
Michael Weiss, his technical merit marks, he looks at those, along with his coach, Andre Weisiger, who we saw. She was so emotional at the U.S. National Championship as Michael captured a silver medal.
Well, she's now getting used to this heavy, little heady level of competition.
You get used to success. Marks for presentation. So Michael Weiss, right now, in terms of those that have skated in second place, but most of the contenders yet to come. And here is the two-time and reigning Japanese national champion. He's only 15 years old, Takeshi Honda. He's in seventh place.
And he is quite a jumper. He has a lot of guts, a lot of energy, and a lot of speed.
He's so talented.
And he is one of the skaters who tells us he plans a quad jump.
Look at the speed he's getting up here already. He's not afraid of these jumps. Now, he fell on that in the qualifying round. Didn't affect him here.
Yeah, he turned. It was supposed to be a triple-triple, but he did a beautiful triple axel plane.
Now, if he's going to do a quadruple, it will be right here. Quadruple toe loop. Watch him reach back. Nope. They all seem to be playing it fairly conservatively so far, although there have been a couple of quadruples.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know if they make that decision after they miss the opening element, maybe.
The quadruple jumps that have been performed were early in this men's free skate. In terms of the last two groups, Michael Weiss has decided not to do one so far, and Takeshi Honda at this point has not done one.
Thank you. light deal.
Now they just had a little bit of rest there. He might go for the triple axel, triple toe loop coming up here.
That's the kind of fall that really is the best. Down, up, right on with the movement, as though you didn't even miss a beat.
Doesn't change your timing too much. I suppose if you have to have a fall, that is.
When he won his first Japanese national championship a year ago, he did so at the age of 14. He became the youngest ever champion of Japan, and he did compete at the Worlds in Edmonton last year, finished 13th.
It's interesting watching this program because a lot of his choreography is geared toward the judges' stand right over there. He's not playing too much to the audience away from the judges, which is what a lot of Russian skaters do. About his skating is he carries the speed that he's crossing across the ice all the way through this program, which a lot of people get tired at the end and they start slowing down, but he's going fast here.
These are very difficult circular steps. Look at that. That's wonderful. Wasn't planned before. I think he just stuck it in and he left out the death drop that he usually does. It's like he changed his mind at the end of that, taking out the really good dramatic things and putting in two little sort of double jumps that just didn't add up to much.
15-year-old Takeshi Honda of Japan will check his marks. Backstage, a little bit later on, Todd Eldridge will try to defend his world title. We'll come back to Lausanne in a moment. Welcome back, everyone, to Lausanne, Switzerland. Our coverage of the World Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard continues here with the men's free skate. And Takeshi Honda of Japan in seventh place after the short program. There are his marks for technical merit.
They're okay. About in the rank of what everybody else has done in this level.
And the marks for presentation, they range from 5.1 up to 5.4 for Honda. Well, the warm-up has begun for the final group of skaters here in the championship free skate. The leaders among them, Aleksei Urnanov. I know Dick and Brian, you've been watching him. How's he doing on the ice right now?
Well, I'll tell you, I just saw him do a very nice triple down there, but here when he did a Lutz, it was only a double, and it was treated very tentatively and very carefully. I think he's hurting.
Of course, he suffered the slight groin pull in the short program, and he was being treated before this warm-up. Right now, let's go down to Leslie Visser for a report on Aleksei. Leslie?
Terry, Aleksei Urnanov received treatment about an hour and a half ago, and then as you saw, he went down and tried to warm up off the ice. When he came out of the warm-up, his coach, Aleksei Misha, said he can't skate. He just can't skate. So far, it looks like he might try.
All right, Leslie, the last time a leader withdrew was at the 1988 Worlds. Alexander Fadeev was first after the figures, which are no longer around. He had to withdraw due to injury. We'll have to wait and see what happens to Aleksei Urnanov. He is the leader after the short program. Here's the man who won last year. He'll try to defend his title, may or may not be, against Urnanov. Todd Eldridge will skate in this final group as we continue from Lausanne. There's Ilia Kulik. He finished second in the world to Todd Eldridge a year ago. It fueled his hunger for the gold, but he says he wants the world title, but also wants to be known as an innovator and a revolutionary. Brent Musburger takes an up-close and personal look at this very talented 19-year-old.
He is not your ordinary figure skater. Not off the ice. And not on it. Ilia Kulik of Russia has been called the future, the natural, the skater other skaters admire. At 17, he won the World Junior and European Senior Championships. And last year, having just turned 18, he finished second in the world. But while the skating community scrambled for superlatives, Kulik searched for something else.
If I'm second, I'm not satisfied. And even if I'm first, but I didn't do so good, and I feel that I can do better, I'm not satisfied, and I'm not happy.
So on the verge of stardom, the daring Russian did the most daring thing of all. He changed everything. In the past 12 months, Kulik has moved from Moscow to Massachusetts, hired Tatiana Tarasova, an ice dancing specialist, as his coach, and began the process of reinventing himself. The great jumper, now learning what to do in between jumps. The athlete now aspiring to be an artist.
Figure skating is not figure jumping, or it's not a belly. It's figure skating, it's jumping and belly. It's everything together, sport and art. That's why I like figure skating. I want to do something else that nobody did, and to show that figure skating can be something else.
It's a tricky business, fusing athleticism and artistry, a high-risk, high-reward experiment. But Kulik enjoys working without a net.
Some people doesn't like risk, but I like that because it's make my life interesting. When I'm risking, I'm exciting and I'm happy, and that's interesting to live, even if it not works.
But if he can make it work, the results will be explosive.
He shocked the skating world first in 1995, winning the European Championships. He is in third place and controlling his own destiny here in the free skate. Ilia Kulik of Russia.
The music, Romeo and Juliet, Tchaikovsky.
He's one of those guys that wants to do the quadruple early, but in the practices yesterday, he hit one that was not very good out of 11 tries, and today he hit one out of five. So we'll see how he's going to do right here. Triple.
And with all the talk of the quad jumps,
we've only seen two in this whole competition, and they were far earlier in the competition. Wo and Costine were the only ones that have done them so far.
Neither Michael Weiss, who had planned a quad, nor Takeshi Honda, who told us he would attempt the quad, were able to complete them. In fact, they didn't even try them.
Characteristic of him.
That almost looked like an edge that just skidded, as though it was not his fault at all. That's a very rare and unusual miss at the end of a otherwise good
jump.
That's
really his signature jump. Another triple axel out of a spread eagle. Very difficult entry, and he's getting back on track slowly, but we'll see if he can maintain through the whole thing. He's not known for his training regimen. He doesn't go through his programs consistently.
And he has been known to falter some in the free skate. You remember a year ago, he was in the lead after the short program. But it was Todd Eldridge who won the long and won the gold medal.
Especially at the end of the program, and he's going to have to rely on that tonight.
Ryan, in practice, why would you not go through your entire program on a daily basis?
That is a great question. I think that's the secret to training, and I don't know why people don't just do that every day. His technique and his air, the positions he is in the air, it's perfect when it's on.
It's almost as though he's losing steam, as though there's no energy at this point. For that to have been only a double flip jump is simply uncalled for. Oh, what is this going on? That was a single flip.
Single flip. He put that in as an extra one after he popped the double here, the triple into a double, and he went into that one.
It's really immaterial. He's just slowing down and flaking out at the end of this otherwise sort of very difficult program. Sloppy position. You know, this young man has the best potential. He has the most exciting face and look about him, as though he could be a great dancer, skater, a premier dancer in this competition, in this competitive world. It's not coming together at this moment.
We'll have the scores of Ilia Kulik of Russia when we return to Lausanne. He won a silver medal a year ago in Edmonton. There's Ilia Kulik of Russia along with his new coach, Tatiana Tarasova.
Here he is with the triple axel combination. This was supposed to be a triple-triple. It was beautiful. He takes off perfectly. It's straight up. And then all of a sudden, he pitches forward right there. It was like his blade just slipped out from under him.
But look at this. Whatever it was going to be, it ended up being a single flip, a non-jump.
And remember, he was in third place after the short program. If you're one of the top three skaters and you win the free skate, you win the overall championship.
Well, everybody has said what a marvelous and magnificent athlete he is. His technique has been failing him this entire year. His jumps are not secure. They're not in good position, and these marks reflect that.
He does have the greatest potential.
Yeah, but potential is potential is potential. It's about time that it began to pull together.
He is in first place in terms of those that have skated already.
Vyacheslav Zagorodnyuk, Ukraine.
Well, here's a skater who could certainly make an impact on the leaderboard. The three-time champion of Ukraine, Vyacheslav Zagorodnyuk, in sixth place after the short program. Remember, though, Aleksei Urmanov was in sixth after the short at the European Championships, and he won.
The music, Alexander Nevsky by Prokofiev.
I am convinced this guy can fly sometimes, especially when he does a triple axel, and it's really a great takeoff.
This entire championship is up for grabs. Wow.
Turned it into a double.
But he did get height on it, didn't he?
It was huge.
Thank you.
after a magnificent series of programs in the short program, we're not seeing great performances in this final pre-skate.
Reminiscent of the pairs competition.
Beautiful triple lutz with his arm over his head.
You know something about that, don't you,
Brian? Yeah, I know someone who also does that.
Oh, very nice position. That's a wonderfully effective position for a male layback.
That triple axel because he turned the first one into a double.
Flip jump.
Zagorodnik won the junior world title back in 1989, finished sixth at the world championships a year ago. The last Ukrainian to win it, Senior Worlds, was Viktor Petrenko in 1992.
The only thing that this is missing is that he didn't do any combination jumps, so that'll really hurt his scores.
What it's missing is personality.
We'll see if the judges agree in a moment with Dick Button. Vyacheslav Zagorodnik of Ukraine in sixth place after the short program, looking to move up. We'll check his marks. And then the two-time world champion looks for a little revenge. Elvis Stojko on the ice next. We're back in Lausanne. We have just learned of a development in the Aleksei Urmanov situation. Leslie Visser is backstage right now. Leslie, what do you know?
Terry, it is official. Aleksei Urmanov has withdrawn from the competition. He was examined by Dr. Salim Al-Bazaz. He is the German team doctor. He recommended to Aleksei he cannot skate. He has pulled the upper left portion of his groin. Aleksei is out now outside the dressing room watching on a monitor. He said, "I am simply destroyed." This is, of course, certainly an advantage to Todd Eldridge. It is also an advantage to Elvis Stojko, who can now control his own destiny. Terry.
Leslie, you're absolutely right. If you're in the top three going into the free skate, and you win this portion of the competition, you're the overall winner. But just devastating news for Aleksei Urnanov. Well, here's Vyacheslav Zagorodnyk awaiting his marks. He was in sixth after the short program. There are his technical merit scores. His wife, Olga Zagorodnyk, on his right-hand side. She's also one of his choreographers. And his presentation marks, there they are for Zagorodnyk. The 1996 World Championships were to be the coronation of Elvis Stojko, a Canadian skating on Canadian ice. A fall in the short program all but ended his bid for a third straight world title. It also transformed him from the hunted back into the hunter.
The biggest thing, if I sit down and think about it right away, is being the hunter, not being the hunted. All my life, I've skated as the underdog. I have won two world titles and Olympic silver. Even on the time where I was defending my title in 95, I had an injury to deal with, so I was still being the hunter. Last year was difficult. I was doing many things, and I couldn't get my mindset on focus. I was getting pulled back and forth to do stuff, and you know, instead of saying, no, I can't do it, it's a maybe or a yes, or I'm getting frustrated and so forth, it's difficult to do. And that is probably the single most important factor in my career so far as Edmonton.
It's a great position to be in because you know you got somewhere to go right now. It's not easy for anybody to be at the top and be at the top and be at the top. I don't care who you are.
I'm very hungry for the performance. I'm very hungry. And even if I win or don't win, I will still be the hunter for 98, regardless if I win 97 or not. I'll probably look back in a couple years on this year, and it was probably the most important year out of every competition I've ever been at.
Elvis Stojko, Canada.
His short program here in Lausanne, another thing that has made Elvis Stojko very angry. He skated a clean program as opposed to what he did a year ago in Edmonton, but still the judges put him in fourth place.
The music, Dragon Heart, and look at how long he waits before he begins movement.
And during the practices today before the competition, Elvis did what I call a visualization run through, where you don't jump very much, but you go through the whole program and skate it and mark it and visualize your jumps in each position.
That wait must seem like a lifetime.
I'd want to get going.
At least on paper, you'd have to say he's planning maybe the toughest program technically we've ever seen in skating.
Definitely, definitely.
Beautiful triple flip. He takes his time. He has a clear picture of the role he's playing. He doesn't rush. There's a nice sense of clarity about his skating. And if he's going to do a quadruple jump, it will come up right here. A quadruple toe loop, triple toe loop. The first time that combination has been achieved. Good for you, Elvis.
He was the first man to pull it off in competition, and now he becomes the first man to do it at the World Championships.
Jump. little uncontrolled on the landing.
So far, we have yet to see a flawless program. Right now, Vyacheslav Zagorodnik of Ukraine leads. Ilia Kulik is in second place. And Andrei Vlashenko in third, just ahead of Michael Weiss of the U.S. And of course, Eldridge still to come. He skates next. And Aleksei Yagudin, the young Russian.
Two hardest combinations performed in the competition yet. And maybe even for the rest of the night.
Taken with a great deal of ease.
To a year ago, Elvis is both alive and in the building here in Lausanne. The 94 and 95 world champion, trying to get his title back, and he has laid down the gauntlet for the reigning world title holder, Todd Eldridge. He'll skate. It'll have to be a masterful performance to keep his title. Most of the audience members have yet to take their seats here in the Mallet Ice Center after the performance of Elvis Stojko.
Here's his quadruple toe. Pole vaults in the air, gets a quick rotation, breaks out plenty of time, stretches left leg back, and goes up for a triple toe. Beautiful.
And look at this. Now, first, look at the height. Wonderful height, straight edges, leaning slightly on the landing, but that's the way he does all his jumps. They're very clean, and essentially they're in excellent position, except for the slight lean.
Well, he told us last year in the short program he was too excited, and that's why he didn't stand up on that triple axel, and it cost him so dearly. He looked to be very determined, relaxed, and confident moment he took the ice.
There's a wonderful feel about him in this program. It's a complete thought through the whole program. He takes his time. He is very slow. He presents himself. It got a little bit off at the end with some of the positions and the butterflies, but essentially it was a complete program. And I think some of the criticism for his artistry may be acceptable, but not all of it by any means.
I mean, this was really a magnificent performance.
And the last perfect six given out at the World Championships in men's competition, 1994. Elvis Stojko, you see him again. The technical merit marks 5.9 and a perfect six from the Italian judge.
Well, let me tell you something. Judge 8 that gave him a six is clearly, I think, very generous.
And the marks for presentation, very high as well. Little question, Elvis Stojko in the lead right now. Todd Eldridge, the winner of a world title a year ago in Edmonton. It's really an accomplishment of a lifetime. It came after years of struggle, and one he shared with those who were closest to him. Brent Musburger takes an up-close and personal look at the reigning world champion.
Success has been slippery for Todd Eldridge. Early on, he collected a variety of junior trophies. Then a pair of senior national titles before his 20th birthday. But soon thereafter, the roller coaster ride began. In 1992, he skated hurt in his only Olympic appearance and finished 10th. The following 2 years, he failed to qualify for the Worlds.
I didn't really have any goals, and I was kind of lost for a while there. I would always question whether I was doing the right thing.
Rededicated in 1995, he rebounded to win his third national title and finished second at the Worlds. Then last year, the ride reached unexpected new heights.
Even though people had written me off and said, I don't think he's going to come back, come back and actually, finally win the world championship, proved all of them wrong, and kind of gave me a little satisfaction in that respect.
Todd left a part of himself on the ice that night at Edmonton. The Worlds were to be his defining moment. First came the flawless performance. 4 minutes that justified a lifetime of perseverance.
You're just kind of caught up in the whole moment. You don't think of, wow, I'm a world champion, You think, oh, wow, I did something great here. This is what I've worked for. This is what I've wanted for so many years, and finally I have it.
Then came a simpler act, which resonated even deeper.
That was the biggest surprise of my life.
That just made me fall apart.
Yeah.
And we put the medal around her neck. I think everybody around us sort of melted the same as we did.
Yeah, it was
that
great.
Was a very special moment.
It was like a gesture that needed no explanation.
I've sacrificed a lot of things for it that, that's why I gave her the medal. It's hers as well as it is mine, and my dad's as well.
And he said, we finally did it. We finally did it. And
that's great.
I guess in his way he's saying that it wasn't just him, it was all of us.
The journey has been long, and though he may have silenced his doubters, there are still challenges. Just last month, the reigning world champion proved for the fourth time that he is indeed America's best.
I've kind of been through it all a little bit. I've had good times, bad times, and great times. You never really know if if you're going to be good or not. I never really knew how far I could take it.
We still don't know just how far far is.
He may wish he could take the whole town of Chatham, Massachusetts on the ice to support him tonight. It'll take a marvelous performance to overtake Elvis Stojko.
Yes, but there is room at the top. In fact, this entire championship has been up for grabs.
But it is the most difficult place to skate, late in a rotation of skaters who have warmed up behind a great performance like Elvis's.
The first, a triple axel, triple toe.
Beautiful.
Spectacular.
Aldridge, terrific in the short program. Remember, Aleksei Urnanov, who led after the short, has pulled out with a groin injury. Elvis Stojko leads. That's who Aldridge is shooting for right now.
Triple Lutz jump.
Beautiful. He is taking everything very measured, which he should be doing. He looks grounded, he looks confident, and he just needs to pace himself through the rest of this program.
Do you think it even entered his mind to attempt the quad after what Elvis just did?
No.
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 That answers that.
I don't think he's a glutton for punishment.
That's not his style. Nice center, nice speed, nice position. If there's one area that he does better than Elvis Stojko, it is his spins. Todd Eldridge is one of the best spinners in skating today.
Considered by a lot of skaters the least difficult triple, that was a triple sow, and it was his least favorite jump, and he did it beautifully. I think that he has the most brilliantly constructed program. He has choreographed rests in here for himself, so each group of jumps are in sections, and I think it's well thought out.
Look at the curve that goes into this triple flip. Triple toe loop.
Triple, triple. He is skating great.
Now this triple axel was where he had trouble in the qualifying round and singled it here. Now that's the first mistake in this program, or error.
It's probably his best jump too.
Straight line footwork. There goes the championship. Right on that moment, it went out the window.
He was going to do another triple axel there, but he popped it into a double.
Well, I told you this championship was up for grabs. Any one of these guys could have made it.
The last 20 seconds of his program.
Well, you see what he did. He gave the judges a very easy picture.
And it may have taken the gold medal off of the neck of Todd Eldridge. We'll check his scores when we come back. We're back in Lausanne, and Todd Eldridge looks like he knows what he is about to see when he looks up at the scoreboard to see his marks.
Now, look at this triple axel. Look at the body, straight up, tight legs, but actually it's leaning out of the circle. He just still lands like a cat.
And here was his double axel. He was planning on doing a triple axel, but right in the middle of the air, he's in tight, and he opens up a little bit, and he can't hold the landing because the timing's wrong.
And that was near the very end of his program, maybe 20 seconds or so left.
It just looked like he changed his mind.
Mm-hmm.
You can't ever do that.
Indecision hurts all athletes in every sport. And there are his marks for presentation. So that puts Todd Eldridge right behind Elvis Stojko, who is in the number one spot.
So on the ice, Aleksei Yagudin, Russia.
So here is the final skater of the evening. Only 17 years old from Russia, Aleksei Yagudin, in fifth place after the short program. And when you crunch all the numbers, he still does have an outside shot at winning this championship.
He has a chance of winning the championship and the most difficult skating order of the evening.
The music, Carmen.
Triple axel, triple toe.
I mean, it's like all of these men can do all of these triple jumps. I mean, it's sort of like second nature. At some point, we'll begin to look at the rest of the skating to see what the overall program looks like.
I hate to keep going back to the buzzword quad, but Aleksei Yagudin has won. Because of an injury, he told us he would not attempt one, but now that he has a chance to overtake Elvis Stojko, you're still shaking your head no.
No, he won't try it.
Triple loop.
If he said he's not going to do it. Beautiful. But you know what he does? He's off to a great start. He looks very on. He's rewarmed at begin by this point, so all he has to do is ride with it. A little over-rotated on that.
He's really a very fine, strong young skater, like all of Aleksei Mishin's pupils, including Urmanov. I think if he could work on loosening up a little, it would be a more effective program.
We were supposed to be watching Aleksei Urmanov skate right now. He was to follow Todd Eldridge, but disjoined us. He has withdrawn from the free skate with a groin injury.
Triple flip. Not a good check.
Having a little over rotation problem there. He's rotating a little bit too much in the air and having a hard time holding on to the landing.
Pumps here on these crossovers. That's a bad characteristic. Ah, triple salka that just opened up. It's almost as though his mind went off it. And again, he did not check the landing to stop the rotation.
He's looking a little tired right here. I think that's the problem.
Well, still a very young skater, only 17 years old. In fact, he won the junior world title a year ago. This is his first trip to Worlds on the senior level.
He's very talented. Very talented all-around skater.
Had a great international competitive season, too, and finished third at the Russian Nationals.
It's almost as though he's kind of just flopped out right at the very end. Maybe that's part of the Russian training system.
Well, it would be a great finish to his season, though, to medal here at the World Championships in his first trip. Aleksei Yagudin of Russia. One thing's for certain, Todd Eldridge will not repeat as the world champion. We'll talk to him when we come back.
Aleksei Yagudin, Russia. First bar, 5-6. 5-6.
And Aleksei Yagudin, the last skater of the evening, looking anxiously at his scores. Very good for technical merit. And he does have a chance to stand on the podium. This is his first trip to the World Championships. That'd be a great accomplishment. And now the scores, Dick, for presentation. And those are good enough to put Yagudin into third place, so he captures the bronze medal. And the top of the leaderboard does not change. Elvis Stojko, for the third time in his career, is the world champion. And it is Todd Eldridge who captures the silver medal. Right now, Leslie Visser is standing by with Todd.
Terry, it is said that it's tougher to defend a title than to win one, and this man would know. How difficult was it out there, Todd?
It wasn't that difficult at all. You know, I went out, obviously, you know, after hearing Elvis's marks, I knew he skated well, so I knew I had to go out and do my work. I went out, I started off really well. Everything felt really good, but, you know, it takes one mistake, and, you know, that's all it took today.
Yeah, can you talk about your performance? You singled the axel.
Yeah, well, I mean, everything before it was great. You know, I went into the axel, I was a little tired, but, you know, that doesn't make it, you know, that big a difference with the World Championships. So I think I just tried a little bit too hard and put the timing a little bit off.
And then did you try to squeeze out a triple there at the end?
Yeah, I figured, well, Elvis skated really well, obviously, so I knew I needed it. And it's not some place where I usually try it is at the end, but I figured why not give it a try. But it was just the same thing. It was a little off, so.
Well, we know you'll be back at the Olympics and the World Championships next year. Thank you, Todd. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, Todd's got to remember that Brian Boitano lost the Worlds in 87 and then came back to win the Olympics in 88. Maybe he can do the same. Elvis Stojko, for the third time in his career, standing atop the world podium. And Aleksei Yagudin, the young Russian, his first trip to Worlds, he captures a bronze medal. From the USA, Michael Weiss, a seventh place finish in his first Worlds. Leslie Visser is standing by right now with the world champion.
Terry, he took a quantum leap into the history books. Congratulations, Elvis. Everyone wants to know about the combination. Can you tell us about it?
Well, it felt great. I needed to be focused. I did a really good one in warm-up, and it just flew tonight. It was better than it was in Hamilton, and I don't know what to say. It just felt great.
You were saying coming in here that you really felt you were on a mission tonight.
I was, and it had a lot to do with how everything had gone last year and the way I felt about myself, and I just wanted to do a good performance and stay on top of my game, and if I win, I win, and if I don't, it's okay too, but it really puts the icing on the cake.
Well, it might have set a new standard to determine this title. Congratulations to you, Elvis. Back to you, Terry.
So Stojko, after listening to all the critics a year ago, and to the cynics this year, who said that they couldn't win in Lausanne, becomes the first man to come back and win a world title after a year's absence since another Canadian, Kurt Browning, in 1993. This night belonged to Elvis. Long live the king. Brent Musburger comes back with some final thoughts when we return.
Figure Skating Championships presented by MasterCard. This special edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Mesdames, Messieurs, l'hymne national du Canada.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Canada.
the sturdy Canadian picks up his gold medal again. And we bring down the curtain, ladies and gentlemen, on a day that will never be forgotten in the world of figure skating. First, here in Switzerland, there was word early this morning that Scott Hamilton was battling cancer back in the United States. Then around noon today at the ice arena came the sudden and unexpected death of the legendary coach, Carlo Fassi. Finally tonight, during the men's competition, first there were the rumors, and then the confirmation. Aleksei Urnanov of Russia would not be able to skate, even though he was a leader, because he had pulled a groin muscle the previous evening. But then suddenly, Elvis Stojko moved to center ice, and the black cloud was lifted. His athleticism here tonight may have forever changed this event with the quad-triple combination that electrified the crowd and the entire world of figure skating. Tonight, at least, Elvis lives. And it's just the beginning of our coverage, because a world championship will continue tomorrow evening on ESPN at 8 Eastern. We'll bring you the original dance, and we'll begin the ladies' short program. Then, Saturday afternoon on ABC's Wide World of Sports, beginning at 4:30 Eastern and Pacific, we'll conclude the ladies' short program featuring Michelle Kwan and Tara Lipinski. Then Saturday night, in a three-hour primetime special, we'll bring you the free dance, and we'll crown the world ladies' champion. I'm Brent Musburger. For all of us at ABC Sports here in Switzerland, we wish you a very good evening.